have a wonderful time. They've worked their tailbones off. And I'm very proud of the 9 years that I've been directing Child Children's Theater. I don't think I've had a better crew. And a few things I want to cover real quick. If you have cell phones, beepers, go ahead and turn them off or turn them to vibrate. I'd like to thank Elizabeth Whitlock and the Cobb Civic Center staff. They've done a lot of very good things for us, and as you can see, the Civic Center is remodeled, and it looks wonderful. I'll get my notes to make sure I'm covering everybody. Oh, all tonight, just to let you know, not in the program, are two follow spot operators, Lydia and Andrew. They did not make it in the program. Saved our backside, so thank you, Andrew, thank you, Lydia. And also, I'd like to thank the First Presbyterian Church in Marietta for our rehearsal facilities. They were there for us through thick and thin. And it's great to have you. Thank you. Also, inside your programs, you'll see a mailing list. Please, during the act break, see Jackie. Go ahead and fill them out, put them in the box, or go ahead and mail them off back to us. And also, talk to her about sponsorship of Cobb Children's Theater. We're looking for sponsors to sponsor Grease and the fall and the spring shows. And make sure I covered everything for our week today. Yeah, I think that's it. Thank you very much. Enjoy yourself.
Thank you. for what you're about to receive. May the Lord make you truly thankful.
I shall scream.
that a suitor do his duty. Though his lap may very large here, set up for it, there's no charge here. Will you sit?
No, I shan't.
Will you sit?
Always think you're the best. So what are you going to do with it?
Well, that's mention of a melancholy on his face, my dear, it's very interesting. He can make the Lord to a coffin follower.
Oh, what?
I don't mean a regular coffin follower, the follower of the grown-up potter, only for the children's practice. It would be very nice to have Santa Fe a follower in proportion.
My sweet.
Thank you.
bed, Henry. Charlotte, stop talking about it. Your bed is under the coffin. Under the coffin. You don't want to sleep among one of the coffins, do you? Because you can't sleep nowhere else. So, sleep quiet.
No.
Ruckus. It couldn't be out then, and of course, it can't be out now. I'm sorry for it, old vet, but you should know. Your mother was a regular, right down bet.
What did you say?
A regular, right down bet. It's a good thing she died when she did. She'd be doing hard labor in prison like
Mine! my dear? Quite a few of them ain't there. We just own them out ready for the war. Not exactly, my boy. I suppose the laundry would be a very nice thing indeed. But our line of business plays a little better. Down it, boys!
In this life, one thing counts. In the bank, large amounts. I'm afraid these don't grow on trees. You've got to pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two.
Why
should we break your backs simply paying tax? Better get some untapped income. You've got to pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boy,
you've got to pick a pocket or two.
Come, 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 come
bit of Olver door. You've got a bit of Olver door too. Is it gone?
Yes, sir. It's right in my hand.
Is it? What a clever one. I never saw a sharper boy. Here's sixpence for you.
That's it!
Small pleasure, small pleasure.
Nancy and
Cobb.
Of course, we're all lately the gentlemen here.
We're all quality.
Quality?
You want no quality of your sort. None of you. Self-indulged.
Plenty of pork, bacon, cheese, and
Give me one love, that's good, bless you. Remember our old tune, be back soon.
We must be real, we'll be back here today, perhaps tomorrow. I'm wishing to miss out a trip, and why is this sorrow? And when we're in the distance, you'll hear this whisper too. So, we'll get into it, we'll be back soon.
Cheerio,
be back soon.
I know.
I'm
sorry.
shining in the supreme. Never was he seen again. Once a night, once a good journey. In hell, I'll be ever ready. Walk in the water, in all on account of my name. What is it? What is it? What is it? My name.
This game is way. as long as life is long. I'll love him right or wrong, and somehow I'll be strong as long as he needs me. You are lonely, then you will know when someone needs you, you love them so. I won't betray his trust, though people say I must. I've got to stay true just as long as he.
Who will find my sweet red roses?
quick. That, sir, is for me, inside.
She's not my sister. Got no sister. Got no father, no mother, neither.
Just listen to him.
Hey, come on, let me go.
See, he knows his sister. He can't deny that. He knows his little sister. Make him come out, please, do.
What the devil is this? Young Oliver, come on to your poor mother, you young dog. Come on now.
What books are these?
They're Mr. Brownlow's.
You've been stealing again. It pays nothing but a thief and a vagabond. Come on, you young wretch.
If you But who will find
no job for me. There is no in between for me. And who will change the scene for me?
I think I better think it out again.
Married. And 2 weeks ago it was done. It seems an age. I soaked myself for 6 teaspoons, pair of sugar tongs, and a milk pot. A small quantity of second-hand furniture and £20 cash. I went very reasonable. Cheap! Dirt cheap!
Hey, you have been dearly right. You didn't have my head. You thought above, no that. Are you not smoking that morning?
Although I was not smoking, I shall snore, laugh, gape, sneeze, or cry as though humor strikes me, such being my prerogative.
What prerogative?
I said the word, madam. The prerogative of a man is to command.
And what's the prerogative of a woman, in the name of goodness?
To obey. Your late unfortunate husband should have taught that to you, and then perhaps maybe he'd still be alive. And I wish he was. Poor man!
Oh, you are!
Fredricks, Bob is my name, a big deal of the workers for all of us taken care of.
ran away to be apprenticed to an undertaker from where he ran away from.
Yes, yes. And do you know where the boy is now?
Not a little old enough, right?
Well, what do you know him?
A little tricky. He's given my idea of life by the lad's dying mother, right before she passed away. That's the lad's mother, now my dear wife.
You say that when he left the workhouse, he went to an undertaker's?
Oh, yes, Mr. Salisbury, who sold for £5.
You mean to say you sold him like an animal?
Well, it was actually Mrs. Bumble who offered actually all right to say.
Really? Then I will say that neither of you are trust are employed in a situation of trust again.
I have still an unfortunate circumstance will not deprive me of my parochial office.
Indeed it will, and you may consider yourself well off since you may leave my house.
But it was all Mrs. Bumble, she would do it.
That's no excuse, for you were present on the occasion, and in the eye of the law, that makes you the more guilty of the two. For the law supposes that your wife acts under your control.
If the law supposes that, then the law is an ass. If that's what I see, then the worst I wish it is that I will be opened up by experience. By experience.
Take a look at this miniature, Mr. Benwin. Do you see who it is?
My Uncle's Agnes, sir.
Yes, my daughter Agnes. And I have every reason to believe that Olver is my grandchild.
Oh, sir. I can't say I've known you, Olver. If I had gone away as many would have done, you might have been sorry. Not for that reason, either.
I'm sorry if it's been rude to you. Can I help you in any way?
I don't know. Would she be trusted?
Yes, why?
I am the girl that took little Olver to Old Fagin's the morning he left this house.
You?
Yes, sir. And I wish I'd never been a part of it. But why mentioned you specially, and I thought if I came to you, then...
Where is this Fagin?
Bye. Yourself, and home, consider yourself, what advantage we take of you, so strong, it's clear, we're going to get along, consider yourself, well, Thank you.